how many sets and exercises should you do? Today we're covering a very important topic, and let's jump right straight into it. First, when we're talking how many sets or exercises should you do, we need to fairly define our goals, because training for strength, training for hypertrophy, while it does have some overlapping principles, is different. And definitely, if you just want to maintain strength in a given muscle group or movement, you will do weekly on average different volume numbers. So for hypertrophy, we generally talk anywhere from 10 to 30 overall weekly sets. If we're talking strength, we're talking less on average than that, 5 to 15, in order to maximize strength. And reason is that intensity and quantity are in reverse relation, direct reverse relation, meaning the more intense each set you do, the less total quantity you can attribute to that specific muscle group or movement. If we're talking strength training, we're talking movements, not muscles, right? If strength is your goal, you have to touch heavy weights. We need to work heavy weights in order to get better at moving heavy weights, right? And with body weight, calisthenics in mind, heavier weights meaning difficulty by variation, by lever, by joint angle, you know the drill. Or in general, moving heavier weights, then the quantity need to drop, okay? The stress per set is higher, it takes more recovery resources out of you, then you can sustain overall less amount of sets per movement. If your goal is only to maintain specific strength in a movement, you don't need that much. 1 to 5 sets, one set per week might be enough. Maybe hit one hard set of, let's say, chin-up, if for some good reason you want to maintain that when you're working towards more advanced skills. One hard set, that could be enough to maintain your chin-up potentially. So first define your goal, and then that number will most likely fall in between that range. And we have a big range here because the range also differs according to your level. As a beginner, you're able to sustain more volume because the amount of stress per set is much lower in absolute manners, okay? So let's take a beginner, maybe 3 sets of 5 chin-up, that's enough of a training stimulus for him. As an advanced, he will need 3 sets of 5 chin-up with additional 50 kilograms attached to him, right? That's, in absolute terms, simply more stress, simply more weight, then more stress, then it takes more recovery. The overall volume we can perform is much lower. Hence, as a more advanced athlete, those numbers will be skewed to the left, towards the 1 for maintenance, 5 for strength, and 10 for hypertrophy. And off protocol, just. Of course, when you train hypertrophy, you get stronger. When you train strength, you also gain hypertrophy, but we're trying to separate them in order to give you a better answer and not such a vague answer that won't help you either way. Moving on, how many exercises should you do? The more exercises you do per a specific goal, so let's take planche. If I work planche using 3 different exercises, maybe planche holds, isometric, planche push-up, and planche lean at the end with higher volume, those are 3 different exercises. That means that on average, the amount of sets per exercises that I perform would be lower, right? Because I'm taking that same number, let's take 15, but I'm dividing it to multiple exercises. So the weekly volume on average per exercise the amount of sets per exercise will be lower. If I were to do just one, just the simple isometric planche hold in order to get the isometric planche hold, then I can attribute all the 15 sets a week per that specific exercise. So I don't, you know, in theory need any more exercises than that. Leading me to the next topic. How many exercises should I do? Exercises. Okay, so we have your main work, you have supplemental work, and you have accessories. This is the exact hierarchy in order of importance. The main work is the exercise that is of most specificity toward your skill. So let's take the isometric planche hold again, straddle planche hold. The most specific exercise I can do is straddle planche hold, whether that being with my full body weight or assisted by a partner, by a band, by a pulley. That's the most specific. Supplemental work would be either an overload exercise, meaning that I actually put more weight in some sort of a fashion, or an underload exercise. Let's take underload for example. Supplemental exercise is still that has a lot of carryover to the main work. It still mimics the movement very much, so planche push-ups will do. If I do straddle planche holds, and you probably already know and you feel that, you know, in relative manner yourself, that if you are able to do straddle planche holds, the variation that you will do in the planche push-up will be slightly less progressive, maybe advanced stack planche push-ups, right? So that's an underload exercise, okay? And just simply talking weight, or again, in our case, calisthenics body weight, it's variation in some way. So supplemental still has a lot of carryover to the main work, and whether you should do more main work or more supplemental exercises is up to you. Both of them has to have a lot of specificity, like we mentioned. You can only do the main work if you're that type of a person that doesn't need any variation. I can stick to the program. I like doing one exercise. I like doing that specific exercise and improving it. I don't need any spice in my weekly training at all. For those that do supplemental, rotating supplemental exercises with the main work or just supplemental exercises themselves, that's a good option as well. Either way, those will be most of your work. Those will be 80% of your total time and effort invested in learning this skill or improving strength on general. Accessories should only contribute to about 20% of your time and effort, okay? They are the lowest in the hierarchy of importance when we're talking exercise selection, and also the amount of sets that you should attribute to that muscle group or that movement on average per week, okay? If I take the 15 sets of planche, for me, I want to attribute it, and for you as well, most of them to the main work. I can do some planche work, accessory, start something with less specificity, maybe just working the muscle group of the accessories itself, but it should not take as big of a toll on my overall weekly stress as the main work and the supplemental, as they will have the higher carryover to your desired goal, okay? The planche hold in our case. So that's the lowest in the hierarchy of importance when you're talking accessory, and you can even not do accessories at all. Doing your main work and supplemental work, if any, that can be 100% of your work, and that will work for you just fine. You know, most people don't even know their weaknesses. So doing accessories muscle group in order to improve, sorry, Oli is here, got me distracted. So attributing more volume to a specific muscle group because you believe that it's a weak muscle group, or just weak movement in general, most people don't know their weak point. Actually, they don't know their weak links in the chain. So maybe advanced athletes do. Maybe once they have a lot of experience, they might be able to pinpoint that exact spot. But beginners, intermediates, those definitely should put all of their time on the main work and supplemental, if anything, to accessory, maybe just 10%, not a lot of time. And the end of the workout, if you do feel like doing any isolation work, but that will work just fine. Most people even don't have such a profound weak link that you need to attribute actual time and effort in order to improve it. Okay? Some people are just about right with every muscle group, and you know, that needed to be trained to a specific movement in order to push that ceiling higher. So just training in general, the main work will do. Doesn't matter which periodization scheme you use. On average, let me just erase that for a second. On average, the amount of volume that works for you will be the same. Either that is step block periodization, block linear periodization, it doesn't really matter. You have for you that specific number right now, according to your lifestyle, okay? So sleep, yeah, nutrition, that that affects the your ability to perform more overall weekly, to sustain, to recover from more overall weekly volume to a large degree. Whether that's negative or positive. So it doesn't really matter what periodization scheme you do. You have that specific number for you right now. Maybe it's more like a sweet spot. It's a range. So you have like maybe 5 to 10. That's the amount that is between the minimum recoverable volume for you and the maximum recoverable volume for you. That's a sweet spot within that range that you recover from. It doesn't matter what periodization scheme you follow, on average, that should be within this range, okay? So let's take step periodization for example. Step periodization, you start with a given volume, let's say with 60% intensity, so that's the lowest step, and then I work, let's say for 4 weeks, and then I apply a rather severe increase in intensity, hence the step, yeah? And then I walk my way again for 4 weeks and a severe increase in intensity. Sometimes you don't even add volume within those 4 weeks. Sometimes you do. I can, you know, start with 5 sets per movement and walk my way up, maybe up the volume in the middle of that. Maybe in the 2 week spot, I up the volume, keep the intensity the same, up the volume, go up in intensity with a rather severe step, and then drop the volume back down, up it again at the, you know, that will be the 6 week mark, up it again to 10, walk my way up. It doesn't matter, I'm still within that range for me, that for some reason, you notice for yourself that works just fine. If I were to do block linear, the numbers they definitely need to be the same, okay? You are working with the same amount of recovery resources that you have to your own ability, so you need to find a periodization scheme that works within those numbers, and maybe skew those numbers if it doesn't work specifically for you, according to your needs, okay? So for me, instance, funny enough, 80 kilograms for a ring specialist, that's a lot of weight. A ring specialist that weighs 60 kilograms may be able to sustain more weekly volume because per walking set, he just stresses his body to a significantly less degrees, yes? So just 20 kilograms less than me on each chin-up set he does, iron cross set he does, that's significantly less stress. Holy. So find what works for you. If you follow a program, for a significant amount of time, let's say 8 weeks, you will be able to notice if you made, you know, progress. If you did progress, stick to that number, don't change it. More is just more, okay? More is not better. That is a phrase by Dan John, and that is true. The reason you did 10 sets, for example, in that program is a main contributing factor to your progress. It's not necessarily true that if you will add more, you will make more progress. You will make more progress. So be aware of that. So find what works for you with the program and play with it. If you didn't make progress, you generally need to ask yourself, did I do too much or did I not do enough? And a general good indication for you to follow is, if you're sore all the time, anywhere, any day, anytime, if you're too sore, you're probably doing too much work. Okay, that's also something I took from Greg Knuckles. That's a very good general indication. I know that delayed onset muscle soreness don't have a direct relation to strength improvements, but it will give you a good general indication. And if you're not doing enough work at all, that's probably a good that will lead you to not being so, you know, anytime. You won't be so not in the bicep, not in the chest, not in the back, not in the abs, not in the legs. You won't be so. That might be a good indication that you're not doing sufficient amount of work, and maybe if you haven't made any progress doing this program, it will be a good sensible modification to up the volume per movement, that the movements that didn't improve on the next phase. So just to give you guys an example, I currently, where I train once a week heavy Maltese and once a week heavy iron cross, average around 5 heavy walking sets per movement a week on average. So I stick to that lower part of the range just because that suits me perfectly for now. That's where I see progress. And as I said, more volume, so 10, 15, won't necessarily mean more progress, faster progress. I got progress, I don't ask question, I stick to this number. Theoretically, practically speaking, I'm heavier, 80 kilograms again is relatively not a lot for a ring specialist, and I believe that I'm relatively fairly advanced for my athletic potential. Those two combined puts me at that lower part of the range. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and subscribe to the channel if you enjoy and want to see more content. Please comment down below what's the optimal number you find for strength or hypertrophy that just work perfect for you. Put a comment down below, let me know, and see you next time.